Welcome friends, today we are going to discuss buffered isotonic solutions. What is isotonicity and why it is necessary? Learning objectives: students should able to understand concept of isotonic solution, what exactly is isotonic solution, then methods of determination of tonicity and applications of this isotonic solution. Now we'll see what exactly this isotonic solution. A solution containing 0.9% of sodium chloride is practically isotonic with blood plasma and is regarded as a standard. When you add this 0.9 gram of your sodium chloride into 100 ml of water, then it will become isotonic with your plasma, with your blood. A solution containing more than 0.9% of sodium chloride is called hypertonic solution. When you increase the concentration of your sodium chloride more than this 0.9%, then it will become hypertonic. And vice versa case will be there when you decrease concentration of sodium chloride less than 0.9%, hypotonic solution will be prepared. Then we'll see what is osmosis. The diffusion of solvent molecule from a region of lower solute concentration to a region of higher solute concentration through semi-permeable membrane is known as osmosis. Okay, there are two regions. One region is having a lower concentration of solute, means higher concentration of solvent. And your second region will be higher concentration of solute and lower concentration of solvent. Then what happens? The region which consists of higher concentration of solvent, from that region through this semi-permeable membrane, solvent molecules start to permeate into the region of low concentration of solvent molecules. And this process is known as osmosis. Then semi-permeable membrane. Permeation of your solvent molecule through this membrane, and this membrane which allow molecule to pass through but resist the passage of dissolved substances. Means only permeation of solvent molecule is there through this semi-permeable membrane. Excess of solvent molecules passing in one direction and creates a pressure called osmotic pressure. Means during movement of this solvent molecule, some pressure is created, and that pressure is nothing but osmotic pressure. Now these are the two compartments. Here amount of water molecule is more. Okay, there is no solute in this region, and this is your second region. It consists of dissolved sucrose into the water. Then what happens? These two regions separated by this semi-permeable membrane. This region consists of more water molecule as compared to this region, because the second region consists of water molecule as well as sucrose molecule. So a water molecule start to permeate through the semi-permeable membrane to this region of low solvent concentration region, and this process is nothing but osmosis. Then types of this tonic solution: hypertonic solution, isotonic solution and hypotonic solution. These are three types of this tonic solution. Now, as we all know, isotonic means tonicity of that solution is same as that of your body fluid, then we can say that it is isotonic solution. It is having a same osmotic pressure as that of your cell content. Okay, these are the RBCs, and osmotic pressure of your solution and your cell will be same, then there is no gain and loss of water in this type of solution, so it is known as the isotonic solution. 0.9% sodium chloride, then 5% dextrose, then 2% boric acid, these are the example of isotonic solution. Now we'll move towards the second type, that is hypertonic solution. Now these hypertonic solutions containing a solute is higher concentration than that required for the isotonicity of the solution. Okay, when you put these red blood cells into this hypertonic solution, what happens? If you observe this diagram carefully, shrinkage of cell is there. Why it is so? Because the osmotic pressure difference is there in between cell content and your solution. So water molecules which are present inside your cell start to pass through this semi-permeable membrane of cell and enter into this solution. That's why shrinkage of cell is there. If you have a 2% sodium chloride with you, then it is hypertonic, because as we all know, 0.9% is isotonic, and more than this will be your hypertonic. Then 10% of dextrose acts as a hypertonic solution, while 5% is isotonic. Then 3% boric acid is also hypertonic, while 2% is isotonic. Now these are the example of hypertonic solution. In case of isotonic solution, your red blood cell remain as it is. There is no shrinkage or swelling, because tonicity of your solution matches with the tonicity of cell. So there is no loss or gain of water molecules and your cell remain intact. But in case of hypertonic solution, there is a tonicity difference between your cell and solution. That's why water molecules present inside your red blood cells entered into the solution and cell shrinkage is there. Then vice versa case will be there if you have a hypotonic solution with you. Now, hypotonic solution means a solution containing solute in lower concentration than required for the isotonic solution. For example, 0.2% of sodium chloride solution, then 3% of dextrose solution and 1% of boric acid solution. These are example of hypotonic solution. Now, how swelling is there in hypotonic solution? When you put your red blood cells into these hypotonic solutions, water enter inside the cell. Okay, in case of hypertonic, water loss is there from cell and water molecule enter into the solution. But in case of hypotonic solution, water molecule enter inside the cell and causing them swelling, and finally bursting of cell is there, or your cell will be burst, and liberation of hemoglobin from that red blood cell because of the burst of the cell, and this process is known as hemolysis, breakdown of your red blood cell. This process is known as the hemolysis. So especially in case of parenteral formulation, you have to adjust tonicities of your parenteral solution, otherwise cell shrinkage is there or cell swelling is there. If you want to keep your red blood cell intact or you want to keep your cell as it is, you have to maintain tonicity of your parenteral solution as that of your plasma. Okay, this diagram will clarify you more. In case of your hypotonic, water molecule enter into the cell and cell swelling is there and bursting is there. In isotonic, no loss or gain, so cell remain as it is. In hypertonic solution, water from cell entered outside the cell, or water molecule removed from the cell or coming out from the cell into the solution, and shrinkage of cell is there. Isotonic solution having a same osmotic pressure necessary with your blood plasma, then paratonic solution having a different osmotic pressure, more than the isotonic or less than the isotonic solution, then it is known as the paratonic, and this paratonic further classified into hypotonic and hypertonic. Now we'll see principle behind this adjustment of tonicity. So parenteral preparation should be isotonic with blood plasma depending upon route of administration. Then intravenous injection, isotonicity is always desirable because directly your drug is entering into the blood. So for intravenous formulation, you have to adjust isotonicity. Then subcutaneous injection, not essential. For intramuscular, hypertonic formulation is required. For intrathecal injection, isotonic solution is required. Then for nasal drop, isotonic solution. For ophthalmic, isotonic solution. Now we'll see methods for this determination of tonicity. Based on first method, based on freezing point data. Second method, based on molecular concentration. Then graphic method, based on vapor pressure and freezing point depression. And fourth method, based on sodium chloride equivalent method. These methods are used to determine tonicity of your solution. Now we'll discuss first method based on freezing point data. In this method, a physical property of solution like colligative properties, osmotic pressure and depression of freezing point taken into the consideration, and temperature at which blood plasma and tear freeze is negative is 0.52 degree centigrade. So any solution which freezes at 0.52 degree centigrade is isotonic with blood plasma and tear. So it should be less than 0, that is minus 0.52 degree centigrade, then it will be isotonic. Then this is a general formula for the calculation of tonicity of your solution. A percent wet by volume of adjusting substance needed is equal to 0.52 minus A divided by B. Now what exactly is A? A is nothing but freezing point of unadjusted solution, means freezing point of your drug. Then B, freezing point of 1% weight by volume solution of adjusting substance. You have to calculate this, okay, freezing point of your drug and freezing point of your adjusting substance you have to determine, and then you have to put this value in this equation, then you will come to know that how much percent weight by volume of your substance is required to add into that particular solution, and then it will become isotonic. Second method, based on molecular concentration. In this method, a number of units, that is molecules or ions, are both present in the solution. A solution containing 1 gram molecule of non-ionizing solute in 22.4 liter at a normal temperature and pressure has a 1 atmospheric pressure, and therefore solution containing 1 gram of molecule in 1 liter will have osmotic pressure 22.4 atmospheric pressure. So osmotic pressure of blood plasma and lacrimal secretion is approximately 6.7 atmospheric pressure. When your solution is having that much osmotic pressure, then you can say that it is isotonic with your lacrimal secretion or blood plasma. Now molarity of your fluid is equal to 6.7 divided by 22.4, okay, because 22.4 is for 1 atmospheric pressure, but for 6.7 atmospheric pressure it requires 0.3 moles. Then concentration of unionized medicament needed to produce isoosmotic solution is nothing but 0.3 mole, where W is a concentration required in a gram per liter and M is nothing but your molecular weight of solute. So by using this method, you can determine how much amount of or how much gram of substance is required to add per liter of solution to make it isotonic. Okay, this is all about the non-ionized solution, but if you have a ionizable substance or ionizable drug with you, then you have to make some addition in this formula, that W is equal to 0.3 m divided by n. So here you have to divide this 0.3 by m with n. N is nothing but number of ions formed after ionization of your drug. Then you have to calculate value of W and you can make your solution isotonic. Third method, based on vapor pressure and freezing point depression. In this method, solution of various concentration of NaCl are prepared. Their freezing point determined with accuracy, and a graph is prepared from this data. How you can plot this graph? Percent concentration versus freezing point. Percent concentration of your NaCl versus freezing point of the particular concentration or particular concentrated solution. So prepared for each medicament, and percentage of adjusting substance required to make any percent of medicament isotonic with blood plasma can be determined with the help of graph. Now we'll discuss fourth method. Okay, getting about the third method. In this third method, just you have to plot prism point versus concentration of NaCl. Then you can determine the isotonicity of your unknown solution by plotting your value of unknown solution on this graph, or extrapolating value of your unknown solution. Now fourth method, based on sodium chloride equivalent method. In this method, a factor called sodium chloride equivalent, which can be used to convert a specified concentration of medicament to concentration of sodium chloride, which will produce same osmotic effect. How can you calculate this sodium chloride equivalent of a medicament? By using this formula, sodium chloride equivalent of a medicament is equal to a freezing point depression produced by a solution of medicament divided by freezing point depression produced by a NaCl solution of same strength. And suppose you have prepared 1% of your solution of drug, then same percentage or same percentage you have to take for this sodium chloride, and you have to take a ratio of this two, then this will give you a value of sodium chloride equivalent of medicament. Then percentage of sodium chloride for adjustment of isotonicity is equal to 0.9 minus percent strength of medicament solution into NaCl equivalent of medicament. Then by calculating this, you will come to know that how much percentage of sodium chloride is required to add in this solution, then it will converted into the isotonic solution. Now we'll discuss how to calculate this amount of sodium chloride required to prepare your formulation isotonic. Now here I put one example. Calculate gram of sodium chloride needed to make 30 ml of 2% isotonic phytostigmine salicylate solution using this sodium chloride method. Now sodium chloride equivalent value of this phytostigmine salicylate is equal to 0.16. Now we have this value with us, that is sodium chloride equivalent of your drug. Then a percent of sodium chloride required to add is equal to 0.9 minus percent strength of medicament solution. Here it is 2%. So 2 into equivalent of medicament, sodium chloride of equivalent of medicament, it is 0.16. So calculating this will get 0.58% of your sodium chloride. But this value is for 100 ml and we want to prepare 30 ml of your phytostigmine salicylate solution. So by cross multiplication, 50.58 required for 100 ml, then x required for the 30 mL. So rearranging this equation, x is equal to 30 into 4.58 divided by 100, and after calculating this, we'll get 0.17 gram of NaCl is required to prepare 2% phytostigmine solution 30 mL. Okay, this is all about sodium chloride equivalent method. Okay, these are four methods of determination for adjustment of the tonicity of your solution. Then we'll see application of this buffered isotonic solution in case of parenter formulation. It should be isotonic with blood plasma. They can some flexibility depending upon route of administration and quantity of solution to be injected. For intravenous infusion and irrigating solution and lotion for open wounds, then subcutaneous injection, then parenteral preparation for diagnostic purposes in order to avoid false reaction, then solution for intrathecal injections. Intrathecal means in between your vertebrae, means you have to inject your solution or drug into the spinal cord. So amount of this CSF is 80 to 60 mL. When you inject hypertonic or hypotonic solution in a very less amount, it immediately disturb the osmotic pressure of your CSF. So person may suffering from vomiting and other side effects. So in your intrathecal injection must be isotonic. Then solution used as a nasal drops, they also required to be isotonic. Then ophthalmic drops also required to be isotonic. So this is all about buffered isotonic solution. Thank you for patient listening.